In this video, we will solve some problems based on three-phase induction motor. Motor which converts electrical to mechanical. Working principle is Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Supply we are giving three-phase. So, induction motor working principle over, concept of magnetic field over, slip and its significance over, and rotor frequency derivation over, star to delta starter over. So, before getting into the problems, before solving the problems, we must know some theory and formulas required for the problem solving. What is slip? Slip is equal to slip speed to the synchronous speed. Slip speed is ns minus nr divided by ns. Nr, rotor speed, is equal to ns into 1 minus s. Ns is equal to 120 f by p. Right? So, based on that, we are having some problems, right? What is that ns? Rotating magnetic field speed, and 120 is a phase angle, f is a frequency, p is the number of poles present in the induction motor. Right? So, this concept is common for all the engineering branches, induction motor, p cycle. Okay. Let's see first problem. Okay. The question is like this: a 12 pole 3 phase alternator is driven by 440 volts 3 phase 6 pole induction motor running at slip of 3%. Find the frequency of the EMF generated by the alternator. Right? See, question is like this. Okay, here there is a alternator present. So alternator gives output electrical, right? Because what is the use of alternator or synchronous generator? Supply is given to the mechanical to the shaft or whatever supply we are getting. Okay, mechanical input, electrical output from the alternator. Here there is a induction motor. Okay, this is alternator, this is induction motor. This is a problem. 12 pole 3 phase alternator is driven. So 12 pole is having in the alternator, driven by 440 volts, supply 440 volts, 3 phase and 6 pole induction. Induction motor poles are 6, right? Slip of 3%. So find the frequency of the EMF generated by the alternator. Solution for the induction motor, ns is equal to 120 f by p. 120 into 50 divided by 6 is 1000 rpm. N is equal to 1 minus s into ns. 1 into 1 minus 0.03 into 1000, that is 970 rpm. And if you want to calculate frequency, the alternator is driven by the induction motor. The alternator runs at 970 rpm for the alternator. Frequency is p into ns divided by 120, that is 12 into 970 divided by 120, that is 97 hertz. So 12 pole 3 phase alternator, right? So, a 6 pole induction motor. So, ns for induction motor is 1000 rpm. Ns is equal to 120. F is how much? F is not given, okay. F we need to calculate now from the frequency. Frequency we got 97 hertz. No, it's wrong, okay. The alternate driven by the induction motor, alternate runs at 970 rpm. Okay, for the alternator. Okay. So, the find the frequency of the EMF generated in the alternator. Frequency we need to calculate, right? So, because alternator rotation is not given. So, okay, 97 hertz. So, ulta they have given, okay? Frequency of alternator. 12 pole, 3 phase alternator is driven by 440 volt 3 phase induction motor, 6 pole induction motor, okay? Slip of 3%. Find the frequency of the EMF generated in the alternator. So, we need to calculate frequency, okay? Not by using speed of rotation of alternator. Okay. Next problem. Okay. A 3 phase 50 hertz 6 pole induction motor has full load percentage slip of 3. Find the synchronous speed, actual speed. So ns is equal to 120 f by p. 120 into 50 divided by 6, that is 1000 rpm. Slip is equal to ns minus nr divided by ns. that is 0.03 is given. So 100 minus n into 1000 is equal to n into 970 rpm. So here you can say slip 3%, right? Slip is 3%. Slip is 3%. Directly you can say 3% 1000, that is 3970 rpm. You will get it, right? Next we have a three-phase induction motor has a 6-pole, runs at 960 rpm full load. It is supplied from an alternator having 4-pole running at 1500 rpm. Calculate the full load slip and the frequency of the rotor current of the induction motor. See, this problem is like this. Three-phase induction motor. Okay, I'll just draw a diagram now for problem. So here induction motor, here this is a alternator. Okay, three phase induction motors. So this is three phase induction motor. Okay, and has a 6-pole. This is 6-pole, runs at 960 rpm induction motor running, supplied from an alternator having 4 poles. This pole, 4 pole, running at 1500 rpm. This is alternator. Okay, this is alternator. This is induction motor, right? So what about frequency for the alternator? F is equal to PN by 120. 4 into 1500 divided by 120 is 50 hertz. So one thing you keep it in your mind, common sense. And also please solve all the problems, because if you solve problems, you'll get some idea. Otherwise, you'll not get idea, okay? 50 hertz, you'll get value, frequency, all the problems. You'll not get more than that frequency, because in India, 50 hertz frequency we are generating. For induction motor, 50 hertz from the alternator data we got. NS is equal to 120 F by P, 120 into 50 divided by 6, that is 1000 RPM. S is equal to NS minus NR divided by NS, 1000 minus 960 divided by 1000, that is 0.04, 4%. FR is equal to SF, 0.04 into 50, that is 2 hertz. Okay, 2 hertz frequency we got in the rotor. See, induction motor start rotating like this. Okay, start rotating like this. This rotor induced frequency is FR. FR is equal to SDF. 0.04 into 50, that is 2 hertz. Even though supply frequency if you give 50 hertz, rotor also induces frequency, because when conductor present in the rotor bar conductor, okay, so start rotating, cuts the magnetic field, experience a current, or experience induces a EMF. Due to induced EMF, current will current induces. So when current is present, definitely it's having a frequency, that frequency is 2 hertz. Okay, that is the concept. FR is equal to SF. FR is a rotor frequency, S is a slip, F is the supply frequency. Don't confuse. Here they have given two datas, okay? One alternator data, another one is induction motor data. Alternator data is for only calculation of frequency, and induction motor data is for calculating rotor frequency. My concept, our concept is induction motor problem solution. So alternator is given. Alternator is given by for only for giving supply to the induction motor. See, here supply we are giving, that supply frequency is 50 hertz. Keep it in your mind. Okay. So supply to the induction motor. Induction motor, this many speed is given. So what about the rotor frequency? If it is, sometimes the last question. If it is rotor is standstill, what about the frequency of the rotor? So zero, because rotor is not at all rotating. If it is jam condition, that jam condition supply frequency is equal to rotor frequency. That also you should keep it in your mind. Sometimes they may ask question. Okay, thank you so much. Next we'll see some extra problems, like examination problems, and also please refer some question paper problems for the examination point of view. Please solve, because in this part, induction motor part, we are having only 3 to 4 formulas, like NS is equal to 120 F by P, and NR is equal to NS into 1 minus S, FR is equal to SF, only 3 formulas. So they'll change only the question datas, and also somewhat they'll twist. So please concentrate. Thank you.